So this is going to be Samsung's best regular phone, the S22 Ultra, versus Samsung's best foldable device, the new Z Fold 4. So let's go and see how they compare. As far as design, both of them are going to be premium looking and premium feeling. The S22 Ultra and the Z Fold 4 both use Gorilla Glass Victus Plus on the front and on the back. They both will have a matte finish on the back and they have a glossy frame. The S22 Ultra though does have rounded sides with a flat top and a bottom, which does give a little bit of a sharp corner on the edge there. And on the Z Fold 4, the sides are completely flat, which does make it feel a little bit more comfortable. The sides are, or the corners I should say, are rounded, which again makes it feel more comfortable in the hand. The Z Fold 4 though is a little bit heavy. And when you open it up, it feels pretty well distributed between both sides. When you have it opened up, the camera module side does feel a little bit heavier, but still feels pretty comfortable in the hand. But overall, I would still recommend a case or at minimum a skin just to add either some protection or add some grippiness to both devices because they can be a little bit slippery. The S22 Ultra is IP68 water and dust resistant rated versus the Z Fold 4 that's IPX8 rated, which means it's only water resistant, which is nice. And if water splashes on them, they'll be fine. But if dust hits the Z Fold 4, it can be a little bit dangerous because it can get into the hinge or even get in between the screen. As far as biometrics, the S22 Ultra does have a fingerprint sensor underneath the display, and then the Z Fold 4 has the fingerprint sensor embedded into the power button, which both of them I find to be pretty fast and reliable. But the Z Fold 4, since it has it in the power button, it can be used as a gesture pad. So that means that you can use it to bring down the notification panel. Can get annoying sometimes because you might accidentally trigger it, but it's pretty useful most of the time. You also have facial recognition, which both work pretty fast and reliable as well. On the Z Fold 4, it works both on the outer display and on the inner display. So whichever one you use will get you in with facial recognition. They both have dual firing speakers as well. So whether you listen to music or watching content, they both should sound pretty good, because they sound pretty much exactly the same, so they're not going to blow you out of the water, but they also don't sound bad. Now, as far as performance, the S22 Ultra is going to have the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 with 12GB of RAM, and the Z Fold 4 is going to have the Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 with 12GB of RAM. So what does that mean? That on paper, the 8 Plus may be a little bit improved, but in reality, both of them are going to be giving you pretty good performance on both devices. So all your basic stuff, whether it be just texting, browsing around, using one app at a time, social media use, and all that stuff, will be just fine on both devices. And both devices are able to do a little bit more as well, such as multitasking, playing games, using the camera. Both of them will perform really well, and occasionally it will see some choppiness, especially on the S22 Ultra. I remember when it first came out, the One UI was pretty buggy, so it had a couple of animations that were a little bit choppy, but since then it's been improved, it's been updated, and it looks and runs pretty smooth. Z Fold 4, I've seen a little bit of delay every now and then when opening up some multitasking, but for the most part, it's pretty fast and reliable as well. As far as the One UI they're using, the Z Fold 4 is using One UI 4.1.1 with Android 12L, and the S22 Ultra is going to be using Android 12 with One UI 4.1. So both of them will be getting 4 years of OS updates and 5 years of security updates, so you'll be getting long support as far as software support. So when it comes down to it, the performance will be pretty much exactly the same, but the experience will be a little bit different because of the different displays that are available. So the S22 Ultra has one display, that being the 6.8-inch 120Hz 1440p dynamic AMOLED display. It's going to be a great display for watching a ton of content. It is a curved display, so if you find that annoying, you might get some accidental touches, but again, you can use a case to cover up those accidental touches. On the Z Fold 4, you have two displays. You have your outer display, which is a 6.2-inch 120Hz 1440p-ish dynamic AMOLED display, and then the inner display is going to be a 6.7-inch 120Hz 1440p dynamic AMOLED flex display. So both, again, displays are going to be great for watching content, consuming stuff. It's going to look vibrant. All three displays are Samsung displays, so that means that all three of them are going to be pretty vibrant, pretty sharp. Now, the S22 Ultra will get a little bit brighter when you're out and about, but honestly, as Z Fold 4, it gets plenty bright enough that it's no issue to me. And the inner display of the Z Fold 4 does have a crease in the under display camera, which to me doesn't get in the way at all, especially when you're looking at the Z Fold 4 straight on. You're not going to notice the crease unless you're looking at the phone at an angle. And as far as feeling the crease, don't really feel it. It's definitely improved from last year. I mean, you feel it if you're like looking for it, but otherwise, I get used to it. But as far as my daily usage experience with the inner display, I tried to use it like if it was a normal phone, but I did notice that some content may get cut off. Some apps and videos will have black bars, especially when you pinch the zoom. You'll lose a lot of content when you zoom in. My snaps are going to be sent in a weird aspect ratio, a narrow aspect ratio. Texting is still not the most comfortable in the world, but slowly I'm getting used to all this stuff and getting adjusted to it. So I tried to use it like if it was my S22 Ultra. So Honestly, everything I did on my S22 Ultra, I was able to do on my Z Fold 4. So things like multitasking, I was starting to multitask just a little bit on my cover screen here. So I would split the screen half and half. Of course, it wasn't ideal because I have the inner display, but it's still doable if you really wanted to. Picture in picture is still something you can do as well, so you can watch YouTube and browse another content. I also started to do a little bit of gaming, so when I didn't want to use the inner display, I could just use the outer display and game a little. But of course, all that stuff that are there on the cover screen can definitely be done on the S22 Ultra, if not be a little bit better of experience because you're getting a traditional screen size. But unlike the Z Fold 4, you can't unfold the S22 Ultra and get a bigger display. So the inner display of the Z Fold 4 can be used to be more immersed and be more productive. So my main thing when I use the inner display is multitasking. So thanks to One UI, there's a lot of ways you can multitask. You can also multitask on the S22 Ultra, but it's far better of an experience on the Z Fold 4 in my opinion. You can use the edge bar, you can use the task bar, you can swipe for two fingers to start multitasking, you can use picture in picture, you can drop windows. There's so many different ways you can multitask. It's insane. On the S22 Ultra, you can use a taskbar as well. You can split the screen in half as well. You can drop windows as well, but you have a much smaller display that it feels a little bit cramped in my opinion. I think the best way to multitask on the S22 Ultra, in my opinion, is by just doing picture in picture. But that's just the way I do it. So for me, I always use mostly two apps at the same time on the Z Fold 4 because you can literally use pretty much two apps in their full capacity on the Z Fold 4, whether it be two apps in portrait mode on side by side, or you can split the screen by using a video at the top and literally playing a game on the bottom. There's so many different ways you can take advantage of it and literally multitask like a beast on here. You also have the ability to use this one app at a time if you wanted to. So again, it may depend on the app whether or not it looks better on the S22 Ultra or on the Z Fold 4. So most apps, if not all apps, will look just fine on the S22 Ultra because you're getting a traditional screen size. So most of those apps are all built for like a screen size that the S22 Ultra uses, at least the aspect ratio. So all that stuff will work just fine on the S22 Ultra. But on the Z Fold 4, there's some apps that does look a little bit oversized and doesn't look as pretty. And you may get some black bars depending on what you're doing. So like videos will get black bars. So it may not be as a big of a difference when watching videos, but you are going to get a little bit of more content on the screen here. And you also have the ability to change the aspect ratio. So if you don't like the way it looks with the full screen mode on the Z Fold 4, you can change it to a traditional screen size of 16:9 or 4:3, whatever you prefer. That's what I do for Snapchat because I didn't like with the full screen mode you would send a big squarish looking snap. So I changed it to 16:9 to make it look pretty normal, or try to make it look normal. But I did find it annoying that to send a normal looking snap, I had to open up my phone. Unlike the S22 Ultra, it just sends it normal. Same thing with texting. Like I complained on the front covered screen, it still is a little bit uncomfortable to use the big display. So I can't decide whether to use the outer display or the big display. Sometimes I'm just literally switching between both of them because I'll feel uncomfortable on one, so I'll switch to the next one. But on the S22 Ultra, you know, you're gonna get a one size fits all. So it feels pretty comfortable typing on the S22 Ultra. But again, most stuff will be pretty good, if not better, on the Z Fold 4 because you get a more immersive experience. Especially when you're gaming, I find gaming to be so much more fun on the Z Fold 4 because you get a much bigger display. You're going to get great performance on both of them, but because of that bigger display, it's a lot more fun in my opinion. It's literally like having like a DS in your back pocket again. And speaking of a DS, you can literally turn this into looking like a DS by flexing it into flex mode. So there's a couple different apps you can use to go into flex mode. So my main usage is YouTube, so other streaming apps too would be pretty useful. So literally use your phone as its own kickstand, prop it up, and boom, you're watching videos on one half and either changing settings or using a touchpad or watching videos and looking at the description and comments and stuff like that on the other half. So I find flex mode to be pretty cool. But again, you could just buy a kickstand with a case on the S22 Ultra and be able to prop it up that way. Same thing on the Z Fold 4, you can just get a case of kickstand and use the bigger display that way as well. But I find that experience to be a lot more fun on the Z Fold 4. You have S Pen support on both of them, but albeit you can't use each other's S Pens on each device, so you can't use the Z Fold 4 S Pen on the S22 Ultra, and you can't use the S22 Ultra S Pen on the Z Fold 4, and the outer display also can't use the S Pen on the Z Fold 4, so only the inner display, which does need that special Z Fold Edition S Pen. On the S22 Ultra, you can use even tablet S Pens if you have those, so that's pretty neat as well. And because both phones are Samsung devices, you're gonna get all the special Samsung features. So Samsung Dex is available on both of them. You can use Link to Windows. You can text and call on your other tablets. So connect them to Samsung tablets and be able to continue there. You have all the quick share settings. So quick share and nearby share. You have secure folder on both of them. Then you also have good luck with all the UI customization and all that stuff that One UI brings with it. So you're gonna have a lot of similar features on here. It's just gonna be that foldable experience that'll be different on the Z Fold 4. So when it comes down to it, it definitely will be down to what you think will benefit you the most, a traditional screen size or that foldable screen size where you have the option of using either a traditional size screen size, that being the outer screen, and then also being able to open it up and get a bigger screen size. Now, as far as the cameras, personally, I don't take a lot of photos and videos, but if you really want the best camera, you gotta notice that the best camera is definitely gonna be the S22 Ultra, but starting off the front, you're gonna get pretty decent selfies on both of them. Honestly, the S22 Ultra may look a little bit more detailed and look a little bit better with the bokeh effect, but the Z Fold 4 still takes a pretty good shot in my opinion, and you have the option to even use the back cameras to take selfies as well. Same thing with video. Videos look a little bit sharper with the front camera on the S22 Ultra, but again, use the back cameras to get a more sharper video on the Z Fold 4. As far as taking regular photos on the back cameras, you're gonna notice that the S22 Ultra does tend to lean towards the more natural side sometimes, and then the Z Fold 4 will sometimes lean toward the more saturated side, or more vibrant side, I should say. So greeners will look a little bit greener, the sky will look a little bit more bluer. So it really depends on what you prefer. Personally, sometimes I notice that they look exactly the same or that they'll interchange and one will look more vibrant than the other. So overall, I think both of them will look pretty good as far as photos and as far as colors. But I did notice that the S22 Ultra does look a little bit more detailed in my opinion, especially when you start to zoom in. That telephoto is no joke on the S22 Ultra. If you're gonna be zooming in a lot, you're definitely gonna prefer the S22 Ultra because the 3X versus the 3X on the Z Fold 3, or the Z Fold 4, I should say, does look much better on the S22 Ultra, in my opinion. And especially when you start to zoom in further, because the S22 Ultra has a 10X telephoto versus digitally zoom on 10X on the Z Fold 4, yeah, zooming in is definitely going to be a lot better on the S22 Ultra. Way more detail, and not only that, but you can zoom in further, even though it may not look as nice. As far as video, same thing as photo. You'll notice that the colors may look sometimes the same, or one may look more vibrant than the other, but overall, they look pretty much the same to me. And I would say that the S22 Ultra, again, does look a little bit more detailed in my opinion, but not huge difference. What you'll notice a difference is, again, when you start to zoom in. Because again, that telephoto is no joke. That quality is amazing that you get from the 10X. Sometimes I forget how good the zooming in is on the S22 Ultra until I start using a phone that doesn't have the crazy zoom that the S22 Ultra has. So yeah, that zooming in looks so good in my opinion. But overall, both videos look pretty good. I also noticed that the Z Fold 4 does suffer a little bit when it comes to the stabilization. You can see that the Z Fold 4 does look a little bit more shaky compared to the S22 Ultra, but at the end of the day, I don't take a ton of videos, but if I do take a lot of videos, then I would definitely worry and care more about that stabilization. So that being that the S22 Ultra being better in that category. I also want to mention that the under-display camera on the Z Fold 4, I don't use it at all, but if you want to use it, it's there, but it doesn't compare to anything that the S22 Ultra has, so if you even try to compare it, it's going to blow it out of the water. And because the Z Fold 4 is a foldable device, of course, you have those special foldable features, so such as being able to take selfies of the back cameras, as I already mentioned, but you can also turn on a preview on a cover screen, so if you're taking a photo with someone, they can view themselves as you're lining them up or something like that. You can also go into capture mode, which basically shows you a little bit of a gallery of the last shots you took, that way you can either delete them right away or retake them if you notice that's a bad shot. You also have the ability to use flex mode, so again, use that flex mode and prop up your phone and use it like its own kickstand to record or take photos, which is pretty cool. As far as social media use, I use Snapchat, as I mentioned before. So for me, the S22 Ultra would definitely be the king of that, just because one, the aspect ratio is normal looking, but also because the camera system on the S22 Ultra is overall better. Both of them are optimized to be used with the ultra wide and telephotos of each system, but since the system is much better on the S22 Ultra, overall, cameras or photos and videos will look a lot better on Snapchat with the S22 Ultra. But overall, like I said, the S22 Ultra will have that better overall camera system, but the Z Fold 4 is definitely no joke. It's definitely a good camera system as well, but if you absolutely need the best one, then obviously get the S22 Ultra. As far as the battery life, the S22 Ultra is going to be a 5,000 mAh battery versus Z Fold 4. It's going to be a 4,400 mAh battery. And honestly, both devices can get me through the whole day without any issue. So on my heavier days, I can kill both of them if I really tried. More likely to kill the Z Fold 4 over the S22 Ultra though. So the Z Fold 4 with like 3 to 5 hours screen on time will die around like 7 at the earliest and 9 at the latest. And with the same screen on time of 3 to 5, the S22 Ultra would die maybe around like 9 or 10 or 11. So not a huge difference. Like I said, on the heavier days, I could kill them. On my lighter days, can definitely get through a whole day. And I even found myself sometimes back then, and I was able to get to the next day on the S22 Ultra. As far as the charging speeds, the S22 Ultra does have 45 watts of charging versus the Z Fold 4 that has only 25 watts of charging. So it is a little bit faster on the S22 Ultra, taking up about like an hour to charge versus the Z Fold 4 that takes about an hour and like 25 minutes. You also have wireless charging and reverse wireless charging on both of them. So overall, the S22 Ultra is just going to be slightly better when it comes to the battery life. Not a huge difference in my opinion, enough to like be the one or the category to define which one you get. So at the end of the day, if you have the S22 Ultra, should you upgrade to the Z Fold 4? Absolutely not. I think if you already have the S22 Ultra, you already have one of the best phones out there and see no reason as to why you would upgrade. Unless you absolutely need those flexible and foldable modes and experience, then potentially, but in my opinion, you probably should have just waited instead of getting the S22 Ultra, but if, honestly, there's different reasons why. So just in all, if you already have the S22 Ultra, I really don't think you should be upgrading. As far as picking between them, you just gotta think about which one will benefit you the most. The more traditional screen size, or if you have the time and want to learn something new, build new habits, then go with the Z Fold 4 because you have the option of using the outer display or using the inner display. So if you're a multitasking beast, you're gonna love that. Now, if you're a big camera guy, then I would definitely go with the S22 Ultra. But for me, I love the foldable and flexible and just multitasking beast abilities that I have on the Z Fold 4. So I'm gonna stick with the Z Fold 4. I truly think that this is gonna be my best phone or my favorite daily phone that I use every day. So I'm gonna put down the S22 Ultra and just rock the Z Fold 4 for now. So for now, that's been it. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hope this helps, and peace.